If you were like most people, you probably scratched your head when media outlets first reported back in August that Ukraine was ready to receive the National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System, or NASAMS. Mainly in the shadow as a next-generation surface-to-air defense system, little has been known about NASAMS until now. This is because the highly classified secret weapon is the weapon of choice for about a dozen other countries when they have to shoot down an air threat. So what exactly is NASAMS, and why is Russia so afraid of Ukraine using it? First developed by a partnership between the US and Norway in the 1990s, the NASAMS is a ground-based air defense system meant for all weather conditions. The system is designed for day and night operations and is able to fire on target data provided by both organic and external sensors. Its 360-degree defense capability means nothing can escape its field of fire. Because of this, it's perfect for protecting mass population centers and static and mobile assets. NASAMS is currently serving with 6 NATO countries and 4 partner nations in the Middle East, South America, and Asia. As for the US, its NASAMS batteries do not see widespread service. In fact, all the NASAMS in the US arsenal are in a position protecting the National Capital Region around Washington, D.C. US officials chose to do this because of the huge cost of these systems. With a price tag of around $34 million per battery, the NASAMS is one of the most expensive air defense systems ever built. NASAMS is not just a missile battery, but a whole self-contained package. While there is a mobile missile launcher, this would be useless without a fire control radar. The system is tailorable to use either Norwegian-produced radars or domestically built ones. Countries like the US have opted to build their own radars to integrate into the system. The US version of NASAMS integrates the US-built MPQ-64 Sentinel Air Defense Radar. It operates in the X band of the energy spectrum and in both passive and active modes. This means that the radar can passively look for targets or actively pulse energy in all directions. Why a user would want to do this depends on the role the NASAMS is serving. Passive operations allow the batteries to remain concealed until the last moment. By not emitting any radiation, the NASAMS in passive mode can stay protected from radiation-seeking missiles meant to destroy it. The battery can then switch to active mode to get the most accurate fire control data, either before a launch or as a horizon scan, to verify that the passive radar returns are accurate. The missile system is also fitted with a fire distribution center command and control unit. This portion is part of the command vehicle that accompanies each missile battery. Like the radar, this can also be tailored to each country's needs. For example, older versions of NASAMS are only Link 11 capable, while newer versions are Link 16 capable. What these tactical data links are is just secure ways to transmit information between units. Because of this capability, NASAMS batteries can utilize fire control data from further away units by passing it through a common data link. The advantage of this capability is that it greatly extends the coverage and the range of NASAMS batteries. Unlike older Cold War systems that could only shoot down what their own sensors could acquire, a NASAMS can shoot down a target that it never actually picked up with its own radar. The system is also great for its ease of use and interoperability based on its modular design. The standard NASAMS unit consists of 3 multi-mission launchers, a command post, a shelter module, and a tactical control cell with tactical control officer consoles. The different components are normally linked together in a hardwired communication network to prevent jamming and detection. The system's modular design means it can be adapted to meet the needs of different countries. By not grounding the system in a particular data link, software program, or weapon, the NASAMS can get continuous upgrades as they become available. Because of the data links the NASAMS is capable of using, the standard NASAMS units can be integrated with a variety of anti-air capabilities, including cruise missiles, drones, and unmanned aerial vehicles. The units are highly mobile and can be transported by truck or rail. This means that they can shoot and displace to avoid counterfire. By being dispersed, the missiles and launchers have increased survivability against enemy attacks. The fire distribution center automatically performs all the calculations that would be impossible for a human to do by hand in real time. For example, when the system detects an inbound threat, the fire distribution center then has to take that raw radar data and do something with it. But how does it do it? When the radar picks up a return for an incoming missile, the FDC first tells the radar to start tracking the target. Once enough data has been collected to determine that the unknown contact is a missile and not something else, the computers start analyzing what it could be. Because standard Russian weapons like the Iskander and the Kalibr missiles have distinct flight paths, speeds, and frequencies, all this data is fed into the computer to decide what the threat could be. After determining with as much certainty as possible what the threat is, the system then selects the weapon for the operator to use. If the operator agrees with the computer's assessment of the threat, missiles can go downrange to destroy the threat. Speaking of missiles, the wide range of missiles that the NASAMS can fire give it one of its greatest strengths. One of the primary missiles is the AIM-9 Sidewinder, developed by the U.S. Navy and the United States Air Force during the 1950s. The Sidewinder is an advanced air-to-air missile with superior airframe and weapon technology. The missile has a wide range of applications, including air-to-air, air-to-ground, and surface-to-air. Its versatility allows it to be used on a wide variety of modern tactical aircraft. The AIM-9X Sidewinder, in service with the NASAMS, is the latest variant of the AIM-9 Sidewinder missile. The U.S. military first tested the AIM-9X Sidewinder missile in May 2006. In 2015, the Army successfully launched the AIM-9X Sidewinder Block 2 missile from the National Advanced Surface-to-Air Missile System. This missile is the most advanced short-range air-to-air missile in the U.S. inventory. It features a highly maneuverable airframe and an advanced infrared countermeasures feature. Additionally, the missile's terminal guidance features a new imaging infrared seeker. This seeker improves its tracking stability and provides greater tracking sensitivity. The AIM-9X Sidewinder missile is currently in service with 22 countries around the world, making it one of the most prolific anti-air missiles today. Though it was true that the earlier versions of the Sidewinder were not great, the U.S. has worked out those issues during its more than 60 years in service. Now, it's one of the most potent and cost-effective air defense missiles out there. Though most NATO countries, including the U.S., use the Sidewinder as the primary missile for the NASAMS, it's not the only option. Governments can also use the newer Infrared Imaging System Tail Thrust Missile, or IRIS-T. The IRIS-T came about as a six-nation effort, with Germany as the lead nation. Greece, Italy, Spain, Sweden, and Norway wanted to replace the Sidewinder as a point-defense anti-air system with something more modern. The IRIS-T is available in a short-range version and a medium-range version. The short-range variant has a range of 12 kilometers, while the medium-range version has a range of 40 kilometers. The missiles are equipped with a GPS and inertial navigation system to help guide them to their target. The missile itself is 3.2 meters long, weighs 87.3 kilograms, and generates little smoke when fired. It does not include a millimeter wave radar on the warhead, however, it is still considered a semi-active missile. A semi-active missile receives radar data with the fire direction center once the missile is in flight. As it goes through its flight path, the missile gets continual updates for its position and where the target's located at that time. The missile is equipped with an infrared imaging seeker for its terminal phase, and the seeker acquires the target when the missile is within striking distance. This matters for Ukraine because they now possess the world's most effective point-defense anti-air system. With its complex radars and advanced computer software, the NASAMS can pick up and calculate accurate fire control solutions for even the most advanced missiles Russia has to offer. The fact that the NASAMS can use a wide range of missiles is another great selling point. Because the Sidewinder has been in service for so long, NATO countries have vast stockpiles of them just lying around. While the newer IRIS-T missile has some advantages over legacy Sidewinders, the missile is still more than potent against Russian attacks. Because an air defense system is only as good as you have enough ammo to shoot, with nearly unlimited stockpiles of Sidewinder missiles, Ukraine can shoot down expensive Russian ordnance faster than they can produce it for a fraction of the cost. While it's unknown exactly how many NASAMS Ukraine has and their current setup, we still have a pretty good idea. After President Biden announced in August that Ukraine would get these systems, the U.S. delivered the first two batteries in October. Because these systems came from the U.S., they are likely armed with Sidewinders and use the Sentinel radar. As of November 2022, at least four more systems are being paid for by NATO to be donated to Ukraine. These systems would definitely be coming from the factory floor. But even though the NASAMS sounds really impressive, it only matters if it performs well. In 2020, the U.S. Air Force wanted to see just how good the NASAMS was. The details remain classified, but the Air Force claimed that the successful shootdown of a dummy cruise missile was the lowest intercept ever recorded. This matters so much because a missile can do a few things to defeat anti-air systems. It can change its course, change its speed, or change its altitude. While missiles during the Cold War tried to go above maximum height and come down, most of today's missiles, except for anti-tank missiles, prefer to stay close to the ground. This is because if a missile can get below the minimum scan height of a radar, the NASAMS would never see it. However, with that Air Force test, the U.S. proved that NASAMS could destroy targets from near ground height up to 50,000 feet in the air. But while the Air Force still keeps the test data under wraps, it looks like they're not bluffing. In mid-November 2022, the NASAMS made its combat debut. One of the two batteries given to Ukraine engaged a barrage of 10 cruise missiles. Both Ukraine and the U.S. confirmed that they had a 100% kill ratio. With such impressive results, it's no wonder that Russia was scared of NASAMS blanketing Ukraine. Now watch why Putin's invasion of Ukraine is a failure, or check out insane ways Vladimir Putin survived assassination attempts.